New allegations tonight of a personal vendetta from President-elect Trump and a threat against one of the biggest stars in TV news. Fox News anchor Megyn Kelly says just days before she moderated the first presidential debate, Donald Trump called her. Kelly told Dr. Phil the candidate was not happy about one of her interviews.
He called me up and threatened me and made very clear to me that he was extremely displeased. He started screaming at me. He hung up the phone.
Trump was angry over Kelly's interview with an author who had discussed court testimony from Trump's first wife that Trump had raped her. Ivana Trump later said the allegation wasn't true. What was Trump's threat to Kelly? In her new book, Kelly writes that Trump said, quote, "I almost unleashed my beautiful Twitter account against you, and I still may."
You might not think, oh, that's that bad, but it's what happens with the followers that's really, really nasty and that can really, really hurt you and make you scared.
A few days after Trump's alleged threat, Kelly asked the candidate one of the most explosive questions in debate history.
"You've called women you don't like fat pigs, dogs, slobs, and disgusting animals. Does that sound to you like the temperament of a man we should elect as president?"
"What I say is what I say. And honestly, Megyn, if you don't like it, I'm sorry."
After that, Trump did unleash his Twitter account at Kelly, calling her a lightweight, overrated, crazy. Kelly says by doing that, Trump flipped a switch with his followers, who called her worse names, she says, and threatened her. She spoke to ABC about it.
"He definitely posed his challenges when he was coming after me so relentlessly and causing security issues in my life and the life of my family. He came after me like a dog with a bone for 9 months.
Kelly writes that at one point, her young daughter told her she was scared of Donald Trump. Quote, "He wants to hurt me."
I think the questions about Donald Trump's temperament were the biggest single headwind that he faced in the election. And what the exit poll told us is that those concerns, those fears, those anxieties remained remarkably widespread, even among many people who voted for him.
Kelly says when she met Trump at his Manhattan home earlier this year, they got past their feud.
"He has a magnanimous piece of him. He has a charming piece to him as well."
In the book, Kelly also has strong allegations against her former boss, Roger Ailes. She says the then Fox News chairman sexually harassed her repeatedly starting in 2005. Ailes, who served as an advisor to the Trump campaign, vehemently denies the allegation.
Now, we reached out repeatedly to President-elect Trump's transition team in calls, texts, and emails today for their response to Megyn Kelly's claims that Donald Trump threatened her. We have not heard back.